So we can talk about phishing email as a bait.
Where the attackers are sending you crafted emails designed to look like an email you might be expecting. But this is not the email you were expecting.
So a phishing email will be just like any other email. With a form, perhaps it will have a alarming message or a normal message, and it will try to make you click on it.
And they're typically asking for you to go log in somewhere, or they're trying to get to know your credit card information, for example. And they're basically a way to get into more detail about you.
Characteristic in a phishing email is that the message is designed to create an emotional response into you. Maybe there's a time element, maybe something's critical or urgent, maybe something bad has happened, maybe something great has happened. Maybe this email comes to you from a person you trust and a person whose advice you would take. And that's what entices you to interact with the email.
There can be different types of phishing. There can be spear phishing, which are very designated to specific individuals in an organization. There can be also more generic phishing, which is sort of opportunistic. So you send a lot of phishing emails to hundreds of people, and you hope that some of those people will click on either the link or download the file or whatever the phishing email contains.
Typically, the easiest way to recognize these kind of emails is that you get a maybe slightly suspicious email, and sometimes these are very well crafted as well, but they typically ask you to go to some URL or download something. What I would say is that you sit down and take a breather, and then go, don't click on the links on the email, but go directly to the online service, the URL that you know where you typically log in, and go through that. And let's say that your account has been compromised, that should be quite visible even through the basic login and not just some random URL that you're gonna get in your email.
If there's an email that for some reason carries a sense of urgency, do this now, I'm asking you to help me right now, or you have a minute or an hour to respond to this email, why is there a time limit? Why would that be the case? Have you seen a lot of emails like that where there is a time limit? If you won the lottery in the Netherlands, ask yourself, did I actually participate in the lottery in the Netherlands?
So Google released a phishing test online recently where you can actually go on there on Google's website, and they will show you different kind of like decoy emails, and you need to see if you can detect the phishing emails or not. The test is quite hard, but it gives you a good idea, and it gives you some good examples of really hard to spot phishing emails.